Everybody, it's Invicta, and we have an amazing ship here in FTL. This ship was part of a run that I streamed a couple of days ago on my live stream at twitch.tv/Invicta, and I unfortunately had to cut the run short because of the fact that one of the weekly shows was going to interrupt the run, and I certainly did not want to abandon this run. As you can see, we have a pretty insane ship. The difficulty that we're currently playing on is normal, and we are playing as the Slug A, which is a ship that basically only starts with two slugs, and I believe you get breaching bombs, a bio beam, and dual lasers. Obviously, we have gone through a little bit of upgrades, having two pike beams and two flat cannons. It's you know, pretty good, not too bad, until you see the augmentations that the ship has, and realize that, oh wait, we have a weapon pre-igniter. Now, for those of you who do not play FTL, you do not know the magic of the weapon pre-igniter. Weapon pre-igniter is an augmentation that gives all of your weapons on your ship, regardless of the type, a full charge ready to fire as soon as you enter out of a jump in FTL, in the system, that is. So, in other words, while your enemy is frantically trying to charge up their missiles, lasers, etc., my guns are already ready to fire, and with the double flat cannons, I think that no one will argue that it's probably one of the best weapons, if not the best weapon in the game. Pike beam is just there for insults, and they do incredible damage, and we have two of them. So this is going to be interesting. It's going to be difficult, even for Sinvicta, to screw this one up. I will mention that I was so excited about this ship, I did take a screenshot and tweet it at LethalFrag, who actually responded and said it's a pretty gnarly ship that we have. So I'm hoping, with the blessing of Frag, I'm hoping that I won't screw this up. And again, if you are seeing this on YouTube, this was taken from the live stream, so please forgive any sort of lack of graphical fidelity and whatnot. But without further ado, let's begin. We have Captain Husky at the helm. And the FTL Drive is commandeered by Lieutenant Kurt. We have Ensign Sinvicta, who is on the shields. We have Professor TB, who's a weapons professor, just because he's so darn good at him. Last but not least, we also have Lethal Frag, who came in towards the end of the last sector on the doors. So, this is going to be interesting. We do have full cloaking. We do have a defense drone, just in case. I decided to pick that up. We also got hacking, which is something that I usually don't get because normally I'm not very good at it. But we have all the makings of a good run, I hope. Now, this run is not run, it's not won yet, and it's going to take a miracle for me to screw this up. Now, this is something I did not know, is that we are actually going to be jumping into quite a dangerous jump, because the Rebels are about to take control of this beacon, and we are not only going to have to fight a ship, but we're also going to have to deal with the APB firing at us from 10,000 yards away. So this is going to be interesting. This might be more dangerous than the jump to the flagship itself. So here we go. I will mention that I am doing a pause mode, not APB, ASB, by the way. I will be playing pauses, and yeah, I'm going to need them. So this ship has 4, 6, 7, 8 crewmen. Nothing but heavy lasers, as well as a Hermes missile. So it would certainly be terrible if something were to happen to all of those shiny guns. Actually, let's go ahead and take out both. Yeah, let's do a little bit of that. Let's see if we can grab the FTL drive in there. Yeah, that's good enough. Whew. That is brutal. Your borders have chosen poorly. I'm going to cloak this. I don't want to take any extra damage before the flagship fight. Ooh! It's beautiful. Oh, and they just took out our defense drone right at the last second. We have to get out of here. We have to jump to the base. And the enemy flagship is not jumping here, so that's good. Alright, so we're going to have time to med up. We're going to have time to repair. We did lose a little bit of hull on that. But for the most part, we're okay. Let's Get everyone healed. Now, I should mention that one of the few weaknesses that we have on the ship is the lack of 4 shields. We do have it, but in order for me to utilize it, I have to, well, I'll show you what I'm talking about. I have to have the Zoltan, which is actually Sinvicta, in the shield room. So right now, as you see, we can unpower the med bay, and that's great. Now, the problem is that if Sinvicta dies in the flagship fight, we are going to have a world of trouble in our hands. So I'm hoping that doesn't happen. And here we go. It's time to begin phase one. It's the SS Slug Life versus the flagship. They immediately cloak and hack. Don't hack our weapons. Hacking our shields is also quite bad. We do have quadruple shields, so I don't think it can take us down all the way, or maybe it will. So we get the flak off immediately. And we'll take one pike beam. Two pike beam. I need to hack the... Oops. I need to hack their... I'm guessing I should probably just hack their missile launchers. I could also take out their FTL drive, but I don't think it's worth it. Hacking their cloaking would also be pretty useful. I think I'm going to go for shields. And we also need to get our defense drone online. So, waiting for the flak to come up. Oh! They were able to cloak while hacked on the shields. I probably should have gone for cloaking. Them hacking our shields is quite bad. It's very, very bad. And on top of that, Husky is repairing the navigation, and there's fire everywhere. So we took way too much damage there. Way, 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 way too much damage. And we need to relegate everyone to the safe weapons room. Let's get someone indoors. And let's vent out the fire. So that was pretty unlucky that they were able to hack that they immediately hacked our shields. That's about as bad, that's about as worst case scenario as it gets. It's also not vent out all the oxygen while we have no O2. So, I mean, we won the first round, but that was sketchy. Let's get the droid repaired. Drone, I should say. A little bit nervous. I'm a little bit nervous. If that happens again, we're going to be in trouble. Let's get everyone healed as well. We definitely cannot allow... Sinvicta can't die in this fight. If Sinvicta dies... I'm not saying we all die, but I'm going to at least be sad-faced about it. And all we can do is wait. So what you see is what you get here. This is all we've got. It is tense. Now we need to be ready for... Let's see, we can take down... We can take down the evasion by 1. For the defense drone. Phase 2, here we go. So I don't have cloaking anymore, which is good. I'm going to hack their... Do I want to hack their drones or their shields? Probably their shields. Oh, come on, Flak, you can't miss. Flak cannon, please. Alright, pike beam's gotta do work here. That was the one thing Frag said. He said your flat cannons cannot miss, and I understand why. Whew. Cutting him to ribbons. Oh, that dodge though. The dodge is real. Beautiful. We did it. We're alive. Phase 2 definitely goes to the SS Slug Life. Well, that went about as good as it could have gone. We didn't take any damage. We stopped the flagship from even getting their drone swarm off. So it's gonna be it. This is it. It's phase 3. Not gonna lie, a little bit nervous about this phase, but not gonna wait any longer. Here we go. Yeah, it's definitely been more than 20 seconds. I agree. Mind controlled. All right, they mind controlled Frag. It's not good, but definitely could be worse. So here's the problem. Sinvicta cannot leave the shield room. Well, I mean, I guess he can, but I have to take down Hacking. They only sent 2 boarders so far. Sinvicta, you cannot die. Come on, flat cannons. We also can't lose weapons right now at all. Sinvicta just died. Sinvicta just died. Kurt's about to die. It's not good. It's a whole lot of not good. TB's taking them all on. Ah. The flax are out of sync. TB's got to back out. We're gonna have to drain the oxygen. That's all we can do right now. We have to force them to fight in the med bay. Hopefully they don't go after Husky. I could hack their mind control, which might be better than hacking their shields, I think. They just used mind control, but we're about to hack it. I feel like we could stretch so much more damage out of this. Oh god, the med bay's been disabled. TB, you're gonna have to carry us. Why is our defense drone disabled? TB, you're gonna have to fly. We need Husky to the rescue. Alright, medbay is back up. Husky, you need to get back on controls. We need to pilot. Or we need to power the medbay here. One more volley is all we need. Whew! That was a lot closer than it should have been. That was a lot closer than it should have been, and Sinvicta died. That's the reason why I said Sinvicta can't die right there, was not only because when a Zoltan dies, they do AoE damage with their body, they explode pretty much, but also that was our extra power that we had for the shields. And as soon as he went down, we got down to only 3 shields, and... oh man, that was rough. That was a lot rougher. That, to be quite honest, however, in all seriousness, that was so unlucky that they went straight for the shields on phase one. They hacked. They didn't even get a chance to hack anything on phase two. But phase one, they went straight for our shields, and that's about worst case scenario as it gets. Outside of them hacking, like, the FTL driver navigation. But we ended up winning. I did not disappoint Lethal Frag. I didn't disappoint myself. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time here on the channel. Until then, so long, everybody.